everyone. So today we are going to read about abacus. So what is abacus? Abacus is this system. So as nowadays you are having your mobile phones, calculators to do additions and calculations. But in earlier times, when there were no mobile phones, no calculators, so people used abacus to do additions and simple calculations. If you remember, we are having abacus in our school too. When you will come to school, I will show you. So now let's understand about an abacus. Abacus is like this. There is a base on which two rods are standing. There is one and two. Two rods are there. These rods are known as spikes. So this is known as spikes. Spike. So when I ask you that what are these rods known as, so these are known as spike. So in this abacus, how many spikes are there? One and two. So two spikes are there. So one rule is there to write any number in abacus. There is one rule, that is in each spike, that is in each rod, I can insert only 9 beads. That means I have to insert beads in them to write numbers. For example, if I want to write 14, that is 1 4 14, so that means on this one spike I have to write 4. So I will make 4 circles. 1 2 3 and 4, right? And here at one's place there is one, that means there is 1 tens. So I will make 1 bead. So this rod is known as spike and this circle is known as bead. Fine. So to write 1 4 14, I have inserted 1 bead in the tens spike and 4 beads, 1 2 3 and 4, 4 beads in the ones spike. So I am repeating this again, that these rods, what are these rods known as? Spikes. S-P-I-K-E-S. So don't call it rod, these are spikes of an abacus. So you must know these terms. These are spikes and the circles that I make are known as beads. These are B-E-A-D-S, beads. So now if I want to write 10, so how will I write 10? So first of all, I have to write 10 here like this and this. Fine. 1 will be written under 1's place and 0 will be written under 1's place. So now see how many beads are there? 0. That means in 1's spike I don't have to make any bead. But how many beads are there in this tens spike? 1. So I will make 1 bead and I will color it. I am repeating once again. Below ones, I will write it here, ones. Here is tens. There is nothing. 0 means nothing. So I have 0 under 1s. That means I have to draw nothing in this spike. Similarly, in 10s, it is written 1 over there. That means how many beads I have to make? 1. That means 1 bead I have to make. What it represents? There is 1 tens. There is 1 tens. Or I can say 1 packet of 10 candies. That means, so this bead is containing 1 tens. So now we are going to do some questions of your book. Only one question I will do, rest you have to do, fine. When you will try, you will get the questions more nicely. So I am doing here question number 1. So tell me, in 1's spike, how many beads are there? Let's count. 1, count with me. 1, 2 and 3. So what I will write under 1? 3. Similarly, in 10's spike, how many beads are there? Only 1. So I will write 1 over here. So 1 bead in 10's spike and 3 beads in 1's spike makes 1, 3, 13. So like this, you have to try all these questions. Now read the heading that show the given number is given on the abacus by drawing beads. That means I have to draw beads now. So now just see, here is 1, 2, 12. What is at 1's place? On 1 place it is 2. So I will make 2 beads on my 1's place. You can color it also, but very lightly. It must be neat and clean. Then at 10's place there is 1. So I will make 1 bead on the 10's place. Fine. So you have to try all the questions like this, and if you have any difficulty, just ask me.